Thank you. I So you came to this video to figure out how to reset your art practice. I'm going to show you in about 12 minutes what I do to reset my art practice. Right here is what I'm calling grid journaling. It's not something I coined up, it's something I learned from another artist, but there are so many ways you can do it. This way is how I do it. I'm not going to talk very long in this video. I think it is more productive to watch what I'm doing and how I'm creating it instead of talking through it. But grid journaling is a way to create something without having an end goal in mind, having freedom to just go with whatever comes out of your hands. And by doing this, you are not feeling pressure to create a final piece or an end product. You are creating for the process of it. So I start with squares or circles on my grid journal, and then I use whatever materials I have at hand to just start creating. I make lines, I see where those lines take me, I add layers, I add paper, I add whatever materials feel right at the moment. So hopefully you have some materials at hand that you can use. Don't go buy a whole bunch of new materials just for this. Use what you have and see what happens. I want to encourage you to stick around until the end to see what my end product is. To be honest, I think two of the circles look really good and two not so much, and that's okay. Again, it's about the process, not the product that you end up making. I might use two of the designs in future bigger scale pieces, but that was not my goal. It just is what happened to happen. If you want to see more videos like this showing my grid journaling process, please consider subscribing and comment below. Let me know what color palettes you'd like to see in the next set of grid journals. All right, I'm going to stop talking here. I really enjoy the sound of brush on paper, so I hope you enjoy the next few moments of the sounds of creating. A huge thank you if you stuck around all the way to the end. Be sure to subscribe and make sure you check out other grid journaling videos that I have made linked right here in this video. So you are here because you are trying to figure out how to get out of a creative rut. We've all been there, and I have a simple solution for you. It's called grid journaling. I'm going to give you 6 easy tips that will help you in your grid journaling and pull you out of your artistic slump. Now make sure you stick around for tip number 6 because it is absolutely the most important one and you won't want to miss it. If you're new to grid journaling, it's a great tool for artists looking to explore new ideas and revitalize their art practice. The process is simple. Divide a page into a grid of small squares and use each square to create a different drawing, doodle, or design. You can also use circles or other shapes, but squares are the most popular shape used. I have a few sizes of pre-cut chipboard squares that help me to create uniformity throughout my grids if that's the route I choose to go. As I begin my grid journaling, I start by laying down some watercolors across a few of the boxes. You can see that I am using blues and greens on one page and shades of brown on the other page. This is called a limited color palette, which is tip number 1. Setting some constraints helps you to focus in on what you are doing and creating instead of trying to make color decisions throughout the process. Pick your color palette beforehand and hold yourself to use only those colors. Start filling in your grids with washes of color, as well as larger sketches of objects or simple lines. I'm currently obsessed with mugs and still life, so that's what happened in my grids. I've added layers of watercolors and ink in order to build up a background, which is tip number 2. Some artists create deep layers of background that eventually get covered completely, but I tend to err on the side of minimal layers. Building up the background will add depth and will help fill the space. When it comes to building up your layers, you can see that I'm introducing multiple materials into my grid. I started with watercolors and then added micron pen sketches, and eventually I will introduce 3 more materials into my grid journal. One of the most important things in grid journaling is exploring and experimenting with new materials, which is tip number 3, mixing media. One of the benefits of grid journaling is that it allows you to experiment with different styles, techniques, and mediums without the pressure of creating a finished piece. It's a great way to play and explore without the fear of failure. Micron pens are one of my favorite mediums to use. The crisp black lines really make your grids pop, especially against the soft flow of watercolors. Using the different sized micron pens will really add a layer of depth to your grids that wouldn't otherwise be there. I like to use micron pens, especially for creating patterns and layers, which is tip number 4. This goes along with building up the background of your grids. By adding patterns and creating layers of those patterns, you again are building that depth and experimenting with what materials work well together. Think about how you can use patterns of lines, geometric shapes, and organic shapes to add an interesting element to your grids. Now, I'd like to revisit tip number 3 for a minute and talk about some of the materials that I most frequently use. You can see in this grid journal set, I have selected a blue, blue-green, and turquoise color palette on the left, and a neutral brown and brown-orange color palette on the right. I'm not typically one to choose neutrals, but I really like how it turned out in the end. The materials that I'm drawn to are watercolors, micron pens, pastels, Posca markers, and collage paper, and you can see me using those in this grid journal. We haven't gotten to the pastels, Posca markers, or collage paper yet, but I wanted to make sure to give you a brief list of what I typically use. The nice thing about grid journals is there is no set type of materials required for creating them. You can literally use whatever you have. Don't go to the store just to buy special things for creating grid journals. It's about using what you've got. Things like collage paper, collected pieces of tickets, or mementos that you have can be added to your design. Adding another layer of materials to your grid truly finishes off the grids and adds that final touch, and that's why it's tip number 5. I've added tracing paper to this grid right here, but you can add ticket stubs, scrapbook paper, newspaper clippings, magazine clippings. I prefer an organic ripped look, but feel free to experiment with straight lines and geometric cut pieces. There's truly no limit to what kind of paper you can use for your grids. At the end of the day, your goal is to get out of that rut and get your creative juices flowing once again. Testing out different materials and simply playing with layouts and designs is a great way to build confidence in your artistic ability and can lead you to generate new ideas for final pieces of art. It's a process. Maybe half of your grid blocks will be total failures, and that's okay, but I'm sure you will have fun along the way without the pressure of creating a final piece. One of my favorite things about creating artwork is the joy that it brings me, and that's why tip number 6 is to enjoy the process. Being an artist is truly a process, one of discovery and experimentation, so be sure to enjoy it along the way. When you enjoy the process, you are more likely to create pieces that showcase your unique voice and passion. If you want to see more grid journaling in action and to really explore the process of it, be sure to check out this video right here. much for watching all the way to the end. This guy on the right just did not work out. It does look completely different, but I don't think it was successful box. If you want to see some more grid journaling, check out this video right here.